Hi friends, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Ashley. If this is your first time here, and if you are a returning subscriber, thank you so much for your continued support. Welcome to the official Apollycon vlog. I'm leaving this morning and I'm so excited. I've literally been up since 5:20 this morning. Eyes just popped right open, like, let's go. I'm trying to like quickly scarf down breakfast and coffee before we head to the airport, and also clear space on my phone, which is not working out very well for your girl. Very stressed about that. So this is just a really quick intro. I will probably not have anything else to say until I get to my destination. This morning is already chaotic, so I'm just gonna end this intro here and I will talk to you all very soon. Y'all, I have an update. I made it. I don't think that I have like said in a video what our plans are as far as like today before we leave for Apollycon actually. So we're gonna go out to eat. First things first, cause homegirl is starving. Second thing, second, tattoos, right?
Yep.
We're getting tattoos. Mike, if you're watching this, I love you. And then we're gonna go make a Target run for like snacks for the road and for the hotel. And then
she gets to meet my family.
And then I get to meet her family. I get to meet the parents, getting good, you know what I'm saying? I think that's it. Mm-hmm. And then we have to get up.
Yeah.
At 5 o'clock in the morning.
You do not have to get up at 5 o'clock in the morning. I don't want
to
hear.
Do you know how long it takes me to get ready?
Then yeah, you gotta get up.
Yeah, I was gonna say, if you want me to walk out of this house at 6:30, I at least gotta get up by 5:30.
That's what I was gonna say. 5:30.
If I shower, and then I got to thinking, I was like, I could do my makeup in the car.
You too. Could.
But I'm wearing a white shirt, so that might be disastrous. Okay, I haven't even gotten to Apollycon, and Jenna already has a stack of books waiting for me. This is her unhaul pile, minus these two stacks. There's another stack over there, more stacks here that I do plan on going through and picking through. Okay, I kind of went on a little book tangent then, but I just wanted to come back on here and say, I know that my intro this morning was a little chaotic. I was literally rushing and was about to run out of the house like 10 minutes after I started that. But I am in New Jersey now. We are gonna wake up and drive to Maryland in the morning for Apollycon. But tonight we're just gonna take it easy, and you'll probably see B-roll footage for what we do later this afternoon. And then I will talk to you all probably in the morning when we are on our way to Apollycon. This is us before we get our tattoos. Officially day one of a Apollycon day, and it is 6:55 in the morning and we're on the road to National Harbor, Maryland. Well,
almost
on the road.
We're getting gas and
coffee. Yes, and breakfast, the essentials. But the car's packed. We have our snacks, we have our books. We have our...
I have my books.
She has her
she
books.
She did not bring any. She does not have room. She has rocks in her suitcase.
I don't know how I did not have to pay extra for like...
I really don't know.
The
I don't know how you managed
of
that.
My suitcase.
That shit was heavy.
Well, I had to be prepared for all situations. But yes, we are on the road and we are both super excited, even though we've been up since like, you got up at 5:15. You got right up.
I did today. I didn't snooze my alarm 10 times.
We were excited.
Yeah, we were.
I got up at like 3:20. I went back to sleep, barely, and then was up again at 5:30. So, coffee is needed. I'm actually still very tired. Love that for me. But it's a Apollycon, so we're gonna suck it up, not be little bitches about it.
Thank you.
So we're here. How are you feeling?
Listen,
we're feeling like we made it.
Listen, after the fear that I had of the traffic that we were going to hit, we were driving and
the time just kept going down.
At first the time started going up. We were supposed to get here at 9:56. Then it went to 10:10. Then it went
10:15.
10:30.
And then 10:30. And then all of a sudden it just dropped back down. And we were like, we're going to make it. Love that for us. Okay, we did get swag bags, so we're going to go through all of that, and I'm going to show you what we got.
Yeah.
It's official. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ooh, it's pretty. Cute little sticker. And a bunch of books.
Ooh, that's pretty.
This is Immortal Follies. Am I pronouncing that correctly? Sprayed edges. We love a pink book. We love a pink book moment here.
Oh, this is a period monster romance.
Do we need to switch?
Maybe.
No, I got Sam Acosta too. We love to see it. But look what I did get that I don't own.
Stop it! I love that book! I'm so glad that you got that. There's like an inscription inside. It says, you may be asking what makes this edition special. I assure you, you don't want to know.
Oh, but I do. Only bad options. Yes. That's a cute little bookie mark. Some spicy, spicy. Ew. We love to see it. For real though. I mean, we love to read it more, but we do love to
see
it.
These are,
let me see, so I don't have to print, pull mine out. Nice. Lord of Shadow and Deceit. We had a download code for it. Nice, a little QR code. Are these coasters?
They may be. I would love to be able to get this back.
And a temporary tattoo, so we can get two tattoos in 24 hours. Wait, what is this? Oh, it's a little tabby system.
Oh, cute.
I need to call Whitney and see where she is. Oh, okay. I had it upside down, but how cute. We have the
literal stack of bookmarks. A ruler.
Nice.
And
page flags. Ignite your fantasies.
And tons of pens. I love pens. Pens and pencils.
Stack
yeah,
of bookmarks,
like,
y'all.
Oh, it's like post-its and
yeah,
tabs
and tabbies.
Signing.
Nice.
Ooh, another. Is this another pen?
I wonder what these, okay, so they're like,
I love pens.
You don't have a ton of pens in here?
Oh, I do.
Oh, okay.
But there's
I was
another
like,
pen in here that I'm adding to it. There's more.
Is this a pop socket?
Yep,
add just a little bit of spice. Little pop socket. Oh, I got Forbidden Love, which is on brand.
Oh, Holly Renee. Pen. You are Sin Princess, and I need to taste it.
I want to know what series that is.
This is the one I told you about.
I got two.
Excited. Unicorn.
Kathleen, you're getting a pen. And now we're gonna go get checked in to our hotel-y. And yeah. Updates to come. That would be nice if I didn't put my hand like right in the camera when I said that. Food is here. Say hi to my YouTube channel.
Hi.
How are we all feeling after day one of Apollycon? Real question. Jenna first.
Beat the fuck up.
You're gonna get me demonetized. Yeah, I feel seriously beat. A lot of standing, a lot of sitting.
I'm heartbroken.
Heartbreak.
All I wanted was the bookish box, bonsai tie, and I did not get it.
Yeah, like we were literally standing in the bookish box line. We stood there for what, 45 minutes at least? No, yeah. We were at least there an hour because we got there early.
Yep.
And halfway through our wait, they were like, if you're here for the bookish box, Bonds That Tie book series, sorry, but it's sold out. And we were like, well, that's our cue to exit stage left. So we came back to the hotel room and ordered Chipotle before going over to the Night of Right event tonight with JLA.
I don't
want
to open.
So tonight, the Night of Right, and what is the book?
Bloom Books
event after that, and then we're coming back to the room and going to bed because the day starts early again tomorrow. So yeah, that's the update. Maybe we'll have some more B-roll footage from lines because that's all we've been in is lines all day. Apollycon day two, and you hear Jenna talking about her mouth getting burned up.
I have a peppermint.
So today, well, this morning, we just had breakfast, and we are going to go to the on-site Barnes & Noble before going to our one panel for the day. Are we doing two? No, one panel for the day. And then we're going to break for lunch before going to the signings. Last night, I did not update you after Night of the Right, which, I mean, it was a nice setup, and it was really cool to hear JLA talk. I did add a little clip in there, but what I did not add is the fact that this woman's next book that comes out in August is 300,000 words, which is wild. Like, they had to contact the distributor to see if they could actually make a spine for the book. What do you have to say in 300,000 words? And the people that were on her panel, they were, well, I think they were part of her, like, publishing team or whatever. And one of the ladies said that there was no, like, fluff in the book, that it was all plot and all moving forward. And I'm like, I sure should hope so with 300,000 words that there's no fluff and stuff is just moving. So we have that to look forward to in August, but the lines here continue to be long and ridiculous. We did get to talk to Scarlett Sinclair last night, which was fun. She's really sweet. We are about to head out, and I'll update you when I can. Bye! Say bye!
Bye!
We are heading to our first book signing of the weekend, and hopefully keep your fingers crossed, even though you'll be seeing this in the future, that we get to see most of or all of our ticketed officers today. And pray for me flying back to Tennessee with all these books that I bought this weekend. maybe we can do like a book haul.
Yeah.
When we get back to the room.
Duh.
If we have time.
We'll make time. The world needs to know.
The world needs to know the books that we saved from Barnes & Noble's today. Okay. Yeah. Talk to y'all later. Bye. Good morning, friends. It is day 3 of Apollycon. I'm not sure. It's Saturday. It is currently 7:20 and we're all dressed and ready. We're about to walk over for day 2 of signing. Yesterday was kind of a chaotic mess and I did not even like update you all on what was happening, but when we get our little break today, I will make sure to do a little vlog to just talk about kind of what we went through last night trying to get like our exclusive signings with Rebecca Uros and Jennifer L. Armentrout. It was kind of a mess, but shout out to them because they both stayed like 1 or 2 hours after the initial like signing time that we were designated in the hotel to make sure that they got as many people as possible. But things have just kind of been chaotic. I got my Zayt shirt on. But yeah, so we are going to do more signing today and hopefully I won't buy more books because I'm already at like 25. Or 30? I don't know. It's wild. So, yeah. I will give you updates whenever I have them. I don't know how much B-roll footage you're going to get because really it's just like standing in line. That's what it is. Okay. Until I have another update. So, this is what you're seeing. Us getting ready for the next author we're going to visit. It's literally pull out your tote bags, your shopping carts, and reorganize your books. Flip your yearbook or signing book to whatever page the author is on and get in line. We've been in so many lines and I'm so hot. If you come to Apollycon, dress comfortably. You can try to look cute, but you're going to be sweating by the end of the day anyway. So there's that. We are finally back in the hotel after signing day 2 and I'm sitting on the floor like going through all of my purchases, and let me just say that I did break my book buying ban for this event, and I will probably be on a book buying ban for the next 2 years because of this event. I think I'm gonna do another video like after this based on like mainly my experience and like things that I think you should know before like coming to a Apollycon.
I don't think there was anything today specifically that was really different than like my experience last year, because I was able to come last year. I was really fortunate to do that. I think the biggest thing though is like they always say have patience, and like that is so true.
Yeah.
Patience
is tried the whole weekend for sure.
Yeah,
not in a bad way. It's just like you have to be prepared for a lot of people.
It's
a lot of waiting.
Yeah, it's a lot of people. a lot more than you think it is. You see the ticket numbers and you're like, that's not that many people. But when you throw all those people in a room together, no matter how big the room is, like, it feels crowded. It feels overwhelming. Mm-hmm. If you're like Ashley and I, your social battery drains very quickly. And then it is just a lot of like waiting in lines. Mm-hmm. Like the ticketed system to me works really well.
I agree.
I like the way that that helps things run. It makes it very smooth, mm-hmm. at least in my opinion and my experience.
Yeah.
But even still, like, even with the ticketed system, like, you're going to wait in lines.
Yeah.
Especially the bigger the name, the longer the line you're going to wait in.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, last year, I was really fortunate. My ticket for JLA was in, like, the 200s, so I was able to see her during the signing times. But yesterday...
We were in the 500s.
We were in the 500s, and we waited...
2 hours after signing.
Two and a half hours until after the signing to see both her and Rebecca Yarros.
Yeah, so let's kind of break it down, because it's three tiers, right? Three ticket tiers: Primal, yes. Titan, and Deity. And we were in the middle tier, which is Titan. And so when we registered, we were told that you will get a ticket number for JLA and Rebecca Yarros, because they are actually the biggest draw for this. And I think we were in the high 400s for Rebecca.
Yeah,
and
I was 482 for Rebecca Yarros and 556 for JLA.
So, but we were also told that for Titan and Primal, like, you cannot get in line for signing day two.
Specifically. Just for those two.
Yeah, just for those two.
There's so many people. Titan and Primal had to see them on Friday. They would not be allowing them to see them on Saturday,
mm-hmm.
because Saturday was an additional 250 people in each room for both Deity groups.
Yes. And so it was 4 o'clock yesterday, mm-hmm. was it? JLA had not even made it through the 200s.
She was just hitting 200.
Just hitting 200. O'clock. Now, I will say, Rebecca Yarros... Homegirl had it,
out.
She had it down to a science. She still, even like how she was moving, she still only made it to the 400s. So signing ended at 6.
Yeah, at 6 o'clock, they had called up to 400 for Rebecca Yarros. They had told us, they had told us originally, if you're not at 400, Rebecca's not signing for you. Like, we're going to have to figure something out for the next day.
No, I think at
and
first.
And then we stayed in the line, we stayed over there. We were trying to talk to the volunteers just to figure out what was going on.
Yeah.
And they came over and they said, Rebecca has seen how many people are waiting.
She's going to take another 100. Yeah.
And we happened to be in the space in line where we were counted in those 100. So we were able to see her.
But still, this is where patience comes in. Because I think initially the announcement that was made was you stay in one room. They're going to sign everybody. And then whatever room you're in, you'll get a ticket to go up or down to the other room to get in line for the other author.
Initially, they had told us, stay wherever your lower number is.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you're done with that, you'll get a ticket and you can get right in line for the other person.
And you have to have patience, because even the volunteers, this was all real time and them trying to figure out how to accommodate everybody,
mm-hmm.
and anything like that. So we probably stayed in line for Rebecca for another hour.
Yeah,
it was probably another hour. And again, she was cranking through it, and she was super nice too.
She was so nice.
I did not know what to expect going up there, which you don't with any of the authors, but going up to her, she was very nice. And even though your time with her was short, she made that short time feel really special. And
For somebody that the other thing I felt is really important to remember is authors are people too,
mm-hmm.
and so
they were there from one.
Yeah, they're there the same amount of time as we are. And arguably, our feet are hurting because we're moving around and we're walking around going between tables and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Their hands are probably killing them because they're, especially, the big names. Rebecca Yarros did not stop signing the entire time.
Yeah, and then you come up to authors' tables and they may, be at the bathroom or something, and they're coming back apologizing, and we're like... No,
you have to use the bathroom.
You have to hydrate. You have to eat. Right. So that is the crazy thing. But Jennifer, God bless JLA.
Mm-hmm. She stayed and signed because we were, We were late, but we were not the last ones in line. So she was there until probably 9 o'clock last night.
Which is signing, 3 hours after signing was done.
And she signed every single Titan and Primal person in her line.
Took pictures, was very like nice.
Had a conversation with everybody.
Definitely. I can't tell y'all my joke because I ain't going to call JLA out like that. But I did make her laugh. So again, like this was probably the best like event that I probably could have had for my first one. And I saw like somebody comment like, after going to Readers Take Denver, I think I'm good on conventions. Like Readers Take Denver, like this was their first year, so there was gonna be kinks. They may have went too big for their first year. I don't know. I don't really know all the details that happened there, but Apollycon has been around for a while. They have it down to a science.
Well, and I say, like, going back to what you were saying about, like, patience being so important, like, there were still kinks that happened at this. Like, just because we had a fantastic experience, like, not everybody did. There was a lot of people, a lot of vendors, like, their boxes went missing.
Yeah.
There was a lot of people that didn't get their pre-orders. And there was a lot of people that didn't get their merch and stuff that, like, just because the boxes were missing. Like, nobody can control that. It's not JLA's fault. It's not staff's fault. It's, you know, it's shipping.
Yeah. And to be fair, we missed our Plated Prisoner event last night because it was, we were given the option basically wait in line for JLA signature, which that was a no-brainer.
A priority.
Or go to the Plated Prisoner event. And I think at that time we had already been like, we're not changing clothes. Like, we are tired. Again, this, all this will be in a different video, but like, you know, we missed out on a whole event, but you just kind of roll with the punches because at the end of the day, you're here. So you just got to make the best out of, you know, the whole situation.
Yeah. Well, and you have to decide like what your priority is. Like for us, it was meeting JLA because that's who, like, that's one of the people we're here to see.
Yeah.
Like, you know, I don't know if Ash has talked about it on her YouTube channel before, but like, From Blood and Ashes, like, her first fantasy series.
First fantasy,
like,
yeah.
It was really important to her and to me to meet JLA and to be able to, like,
tell her that.
Spend that few minutes with her versus going to, you know, the Plated Prisoner party. It's just you have to decide, like, what your priority is and, like, what, how you want your experience to be. Like, there's just a lot. A lot that goes into it, you know, it's definitely, like, last year I did zero planning and I was super overwhelmed.
Yeah.
Like, I highly recommend, like, at the very base, just deciding what authors you want to see and marking them off on a map.
Right, yes, Like, I will say, like, I'm glad I'm going with somebody who's done this before because she got us through this trip and, like, we made the best out of the whole situation, like, yesterday, we got a lot done. Like, even with all the kinks.
And yesterday felt, like, I said to Ash earlier in the elevator on the way back up, like, yesterday felt so chaotic. It felt like we did nothing, and it felt like we got nothing done. And then today, we were going back, and we were like, well, who do we have left to see? And it was like, oh, we've seen everybody.
Yeah,
like, we really don't have a lot of people left that we're like, we need to meet them. Mm-hmm. And it really, it
like,
gave
we were
us
able
the opportunity to kind of just walk around and, like,
meet new authors. Yeah.
Like, new to us, get a bunch of books. Like, we got introduced to
Bella Matthews, Victoria Eden,
Miranda Hanfloor.
Yeah. Oh,
Her assistants were here.
Yeah.
They stepped in for
nice.
Her. She unfortunately had a family emergency that she had to cancel for literally the day before.
Mm-hmm.
And two of her longtime friends stepped in and came as her assistants to, like, sell her stuff.
And hyped her up. And made us buy a whole series. I think I'm gonna wrap this up, like, right here, not the video, but, like, wrap
this
up this section. The next clips you'll probably see will probably be from the after party tonight.
Woo!
Yes.
The one time we're gonna dress up,
right? The one time we're gonna change into our second outfit.
Biggest tip, comfort, dress comfortable.
This is gonna sound crazy, but once you score your Apollycon ticket, start walking now. Like,
yes,
walk a mile a day.
We were not prepared.
No,
these
feet, these ankles, these legs, these thighs,
swollen.
This back is like, girl,
swollen and hurting.
What are we doing? start exercising. That's it. We're going to end it right there. 2 days since I have made it home from Apollycon, and I did not vlog like the last day and like our ride home or anything like that, because honestly, from before the after party that you did see a few clips from until I got home with all of my items, your girl was stressed to the max. Okay, Saturday I quickly realized that there was no way I was gonna be able to bring home all of the books that I acquired at Apollycon, and also the books that Jenna had set aside for me at her house. So when we got back to New Jersey on Sunday afternoon, I had to go buy a suitcase, and we got the suitcase back to her house. Everything got packed up. I mean, I had books. One suitcase was full of books. One suitcase, one half of it was full of books. I had a carry-on tote bag, one of the bags that I got at Apollycon that had about 6 books in it, and then like everything else that I could take on the plane that wasn't like liquids or anything like that. And I still had a book in my purse. So I get to the airport, I check in for my flight, and I take my suitcases up to be weighed, and one is 12 pounds over the weight and the other is 17 pounds over the weight limit. So not only did I have to buy a totally different suitcase, I also had to pay for the overweight shipping. The overweight cost to even get my books on the plane. So at that point, I just paid the fee and prayed to the heavens that my suitcases were put on the plane. Fast forward to getting to Nashville, my husband and I are standing there watching the suitcases come up on the conveyor belt. I see my brand new suitcase immediately get that bad boy off. But also, in front of that, I thought I saw my suitcase, my other suitcase. And so my husband pulls them both off. We're walking to the car. We're loading the suitcases up. The new one, I knew immediately. She is mine. Because I, in my head, when I bought it, I needed a color that was going to stand out. I check the tag on the other suitcase. She is not mine. So at this point, I'm panicking because there are hundreds of dollars worth of books still circulating the conveyor at the Nashville airport. So we book it back inside. Luckily, by the time we get up to the conveyor, it is still there. Like, the suitcase is on the conveyor belt. So that was my scare, but I was very happy to get all the books home, even though it was extremely emotional. This is actually my second time filming the outro. I had sat down yesterday morning and quickly held up all the books that I got at Apollycon. And when I went back to go edit it, I'm like, this will not do. I want to actually take the time to show you, especially the special editions and like the books that we got while there, that were given to us. I really wanted to take the time to show you those because they're beautiful. So this is me refilming the outro, But what I want to also quickly say is Apollycon was an amazing experience. It was overwhelming. It was a lot packed into 3 days, but I could not have asked for a better experience of my first like book convention. I already cannot wait to go to another one. I hope that I get to go to a Apollycon again next year. So many like standout moments, and I'm just gonna try to quickly rattle those off. The first being able to meet QB Tyler, who is one of my favorite authors. She was extremely nice to me, and to be able to tell her that she has been a vision for me, like to see what you want to become, a woman of color who is writing in the romance genre and writing taboo, not like staying in the confines that we tend to get put in, was pretty epic to me. Meeting JLA and telling her that from Blood and Ash was the first romantic fantasy book series that I read, devoured, fell in love with, got my first fantasy book boyfriend. Like, that was amazing in and of itself. Meeting so many authors on the signing floor, specifically KJ Sutton, Sophie Lark, Sierra Simone, oh my gosh, Hannah Mayer, just being in the presence of those writers. And I took my Apollycon yearbook, and that's what I had them sign because I didn't want to ship books really. And like, I just kind of asked them like if they would leave me like a tip or inspiration like for my own writing journey, and so many of them were so willing to do so, but not only write it down for me but talk to me and have a real conversation about being an author and about writing and following the passion, following the muse, you know, forgetting the naysayers or not looking into like the judgment of authors and how you should be writing, how fast, what tropes you should be writing, like writing to market, writing for yourself versus writing to market. Like, so much inspiration just meant the world to me. I came back home feeling two entirely different feelings of joy, if that even makes sense. Like, as a reader, it really made me step back and say like, okay, I want to get back to a place where I am truly reading to enjoy the book that is in my hand and not reading to have a book to talk about. And I know that sounds crazy, but you know, it's very easy to get like mixed up in like the Bookstagram and the BookTubes, which I love doing this, but the authenticity of it and not so much the how many books of it. Like, what y'all saw from this first quarter of the year is not my reading pace whatsoever. A lot of it was audiobooks, but also a lot of it was prepping for Apollycon, so I was trying to like shove as many books in as possible. But now I'm to the point where I'm like, I can really like take my time with books again and fall in love with characters and fall in love with the words and have a real connection with stories. So that's what I felt from a writer's point of view. I mean, from a reader's point of view. From a writing point of view, I felt like everybody was at the point that I'm at some point in their career. And I feel like I can take the advice that was given in that book and probably do a whole other video of it and just talk about some of the things that I have felt and like the insecurities and like the emotions that I have felt as a writer. Oh my gosh, I am tearing up. The emotions that I have felt as a writer throughout this whole process and what the validation of their words meant to me and talking to them, whole other level. So we're not gonna cry, not today, because we are happy. So what you can expect moving forward is I plan to do a video of all the books, all 66 of the books that I brought home from Apollycon, and just one long book haul. That's what we're gonna do. And I'm also hoping to do a video of like lessons learned, like the things I would advise if you plan on going to Apollycon or a book convention at all, just, you know, what I learned and kind of how we prepped. And honestly, our preparation gave us the best, like, I don't even know how to explain it, like the best case scenario on the signing floor both days. So yeah, all of that is definitely to come. So I'm going to end this here. If you like this video, if you enjoyed this video, thank you so much for watching. Please hit the like button. If you have not subscribed, please do so. I have so much content plans that this conference has inspired within me. And if, again, you're liking what you see on my channel, please be sure to share so that all your bookish friends can find my page. And I will see you all in the next one. Bye.